Hey guys, and welcome to Nomadic Dmitry channel. So today we're going to talk about Darwin and OpenDarwin. What is Darwin in the context of operating system? Darwin is the core of macOS. It's been a technology that built in macOS for the past 20 years. I mean, the earlier versions were even before that. It's at the core of macOS those days, and it's still like a modern technology. It's still very relevant, very necessary, very, very, very good system for average user and for developers and for many users. Darwin is based on multiple technologies. I even wrote those down. So it's NeXTSTEP, BSD, and Mach. NeXTSTEP was the project that Steve Jobs and his team worked on before Apple. Since Apple bought NeXTSTEP and Jobs became part of the Apple team, the NeXTSTEP was integrated into the macOS basically, and it still can be visible because of, like, if you go to the Xcode and start writing some code, you'll see the NS prefix to some specific methods. So basically, it's still a core of macOS and still there. In some places, it's very, very visible. So it's still the core of macOS. Also, interesting fact, Apple was more open to talking to open source community before. So for that reason, they have released the binaries of Darwin, basically compiled binaries of Darwin to multiple range of operating systems, and this was called OpenDarwin. OpenDarwin is an abandoned project because in 2006 it was abandoned, and the last release was in 2004. I actually have a copy of OpenDarwin right here. It's a bit of a challenge to find it actually those days because most of the links are dead and you cannot download it. So while Darwin is open source and you can still download sources of operating system, but you of course need to compile it yourself. But OpenDarwin was a compiled version. You can just burn it on your CD and run it to your basically any machine. So for that reason, it was always interesting to me. So after OpenDarwin, there is also PureDarwin. There is also other attempts to make it like a full-fledged operating system, but it all like failed because nobody seems to like Darwin except like when it's integrated macOS. I mean, that seems to be like what's happening. But I was always curious about what if I just go ahead and install this on my machine. So I initially started with installing this on a virtual machine, and well, those attempts failed because in virtual machine, I don't know, I tried adjusting settings, I tried changing settings there and there, I tried to use SATA controllers, I tried to use IDE controllers, but in all those attempts I failed and basically operating system never loaded. So I decided, alright, I'm gonna try to install this on my other machines, on like my laptop, on my modern machine. And modern machines, it didn't work, again it didn't load it, just got stuck at a specific point because it's all outdated, right? You remember, it's 2004, so it's outdated, you cannot install it on the modern hardware. So I decided just to grab my IBM ThinkPad T42 and install on it. I installed it on a flash drive actually, and well, I was able to install it. The installation is a typical installation of operating system of the FreeBSD type, right? You specify the source where you want to install it, you specify and other things. It's all like text-based installer. It's simple to follow, very, very simple and very fast. I decided that I want to install GNOME or at least just X Windows system just on top of it, just to have something like to be able to work with Windows and like a graphical interface. Alright, so for that reason I've decided that I'm gonna use MacPorts. I actually have a video about MacPorts where I was installing MacPorts on my current macOS installation. And yeah, it works fine, it's a great package management system. But when I tried to install the latest version, of course it didn't work. I mean, I expected that it will not work. And so I decided to grab the older versions, like the one from 2004. And of course there was a graphical installer for the macOS, but there was no console installer because remember, Darwin is just a console. There is no graphical interface there. So I tried to install MacPorts with the console installer that I grabbed there. And again, it didn't work. It just like didn't install. So my next attempt was grabbing Mac OS Tiger CD, which I still have. So I decided just to grab the disk. And I remember that on Mac OS Tiger CD, there was X11 Windows system. It was not installed by default, but there was optional installer. And you can grab files out of it and try to plug to Darwin, for example. And I tried to manually just copy those packages to my Darwin system. I remember I installed on a flash drive, so I plugged the flash drive to my Mac. And I tried to copy all those files. And after I copied it, well, the system didn't start it. So I guess there's no simple solution to it. I was like, all right. But it was interesting to explore the OpenDarwin because remember, it's using HFS Plus file system, which is like Apple operating system. It has many files that you have on your Mac. And there's even one of the games, like chess.app, is also on that OpenDarwin. I was curious because I saw the screenshot on the Wikipedia with GNOME and X11 system installed, and I thought I'm gonna do the same if I just grab the OpenDarwin CD, and probably I thought that there would be a graphical interface, some package available, some optional installed on CD itself, but I was wrong, and there was no graphical interface, and the package managers, there was no package manager, of course. Well, I didn't expect that there will be a package manager, but still I thought maybe. So, but I mean, again, they're just a stripped down version of macOS. Well, we cannot call it macOS, right? Because this is like the core, just the kernel and the extensions. If you want to do something useful with it, of course, you can install some console applications there, like Midnight Commander, stuff like that, like interact with the network. The network was working fine because I plugged my network cable and it worked fine. I don't know what to do with it because it's a 16 years old operating system. I think you will have much more luck with if you use the actual Darwin and compile it from source, and then you're gonna just use it on your system. But again, it takes time, and to get some operational system, it will get some time to get it. And then what's the point again? Because you can just grab FreeBSD. Well, FreeBSD, of course, is like very, very similar to this. Of course, not exactly the same because, as I said, there are multiple modules that are built in the macOS core. I thought that FreeBSD is probably a better match. You can just go ahead and install it, and there's a nice package installer there. You can install packages all you want. You don't need to even compile stuff. OpenDarwin makes no sense, no practical sense to even try. I thought that there'll be some interesting things there, and well, there was some things right installed, like the file structure there. Folder structure, but again, I mean, I will not suggest you to try that. Here it is, guys. So OpenDarwin, PureDarwin, of course, were great attempts to have some open source community version of Mac OS Core, but all those attempts essentially failed in my opinion, because Apple didn't support it anymore. Apple was not interesting to get involved in those. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, press the like button, and there will be more videos. Thank you.